labs acknowledged by their government, but they were willing to suppress all the voices who would speak out in opposition. Somewhere, right now, the communist scientists were doing the same type of experiments this five-story brown complex and its basement levels had been created for. Brenner's employers would be reminded of this whenever they forgot or had too many questions, so his work remained a top priority. Eight continued to sleep as he got out and walked around to her door. He slowly opened it, pressing her back so she wouldn't tumble out into the parking lot. He'd sedated her for safety while traveling. She was too important an asset to leave to other people. Thus far, the other subject's abilities had proven disappointing. Eight? He crouched by the seat and gave her shoulder a gentle shake. The girl shook her head, keeping her eyes shut.
Kali,
she mumbled. Her real name. She insisted on it. Usually he didn't humor her, but today was special.
Kali, wake up, he said. You're home.
She blinked, a spark lighting in her eyes. She had misunderstood.
Your new home, he added.
The spark dimmed.
You'll like it here.
He helped her sit upright and coaxed her forward. He extended his hand.
Now Papa needs you to walk in like a big girl, and then you can go back to sleep.
At last she reached out and slid her small hand into his. As they approached the front doors, he put the most pleasant smile in his arsenal on his lips. He expected the current acting administrator to greet him, but instead found a long line of lab-coated men and one woman waiting. The professional staff of his group, he supposed, and all of them radiating a queasy case of nerves. A tanned man with a lined face, too much time out of doors, stepped forward and offered his hand. He looked at Eight, then back at Dr. Brenner. His rimmed glasses were smudged.
Dr. Brenner, I'm Dr. Richard Moses, acting principal investigator. We're so excited to have you here, someone of your caliber. We wanted you to meet the entire team right away, and this must be...
I'm Kali,
the girl said with drowsy effort. A very sleepy young lady who would like to see her new room. Dr. Brenner sidestepped the man's hand. I believe I asked for one set apart, and then I'd like to meet the subjects you've brought on board. Brenner spotted the doors off the lobby that looked the most secure and headed in their direction with Eight. Silence trailed him for a long moment. His smile became almost real before disappearing. Dr. Moses of the smudged glasses scrambled and caught up with him, the others a clattering rush right behind. Moses lunged ahead to buzz an intercom and gave his name. There was an unsettled hum of conversation among the other doctors and lab associates who followed them.
Of course, the subjects haven't been prepared, Dr. Moses said as the double doors swung open.
He kept glancing at Kali, who was getting more alert by the second, taking in their surroundings. No time to waste getting her settled in. Two armed soldiers stood matchstick straight just inside the doors, an optimistic sign that at least the security wasn't subpar. They checked Dr. Moses' badge, and he waved them away from a similar check of Dr. Brenner.
He hasn't gotten his ID yet, he said.
The men moved as if they might challenge Dr. Moses, and Brenner's approval rose another notch.
I'll have it next time I come through, he said, and we'll get you copies of the subject's paperwork.
He nodded discreetly to indicate Eight. The soldier inclined his head and the entire group passed.
I specified I wanted to meet the new subjects when I arrived, Dr. Brenner said, so it shouldn't come as a surprise.
We thought you'd just be observing, Dr. Moses said. Should we set some parameters, prepare them for your visit? It might disrupt the work we've been doing. The psychedelics make some of them paranoid.
Dr. Brenner held up his free hand.
No, I don't think that, or I'd have said it. Now, where are we going?
Light fixtures dangled above the long hallway, emitting the ghastly glow that so often illuminated scientific discovery in the shadow world. For the first time that morning, Dr. Brenner felt like he could make this a home.
This way, Dr. Moses said.
He found the lone woman on the professional staff in the herd and addressed her.
Dr. Parks, can you arrange for one of the orderlies to bring the girl some food?
Her lips tightened at being sent to do the equivalent of woman's work, but she nodded. To Dr. Brenner's relief, Eight stayed quiet, and they soon came to a small room with a child-sized bunk bed and drawing table. He'd asked